Clips are the basic unit when creating music in Live or on Push. They can either be audio in the form of samples or loops, or they can be MIDI to trigger notes, melodies, or chords from devices. In this video, we're going to look in a little bit more detail about how clips work on Push and how you can access certain parameters. In the session mode, you're able to access and playback all your audio and MIDI clips. In this particular case, let's have a look at an audio track that contains my drum loop audio clips. I'm going to solo this particular track so that we can hear this in more detail. By pressing the clip button, I'm able to actually access and see the audio clip as a waveform display. And above the waveform display, I have several parameters that I can tweak and change. I can change the gain of the particular audio, as well as transpose the clip up or down. Since the audio clip is warped, I can also make use of the different warp algorithms should I need to improve the audio quality of the warped sample. The parameters on the left side of the display allow me to manipulate the loop length and start positions of the audio clip. By holding down the shift button, I can actually change the length of the loop in real time with a fine resolution. I can use the zoom function to zoom into the actual wavelength of the loop. By holding down the shift button again and turning the loop position encoder, I can actually change the position of where the loop should be in the audio clip. Finally, I can also adjust the start offset, meaning where the actual audio clip will start when it is launched, by holding down the shift button and turning the start offset. So in the clip mode, you can also access and manipulate some of the parameters of MIDI clips. You can change the loop position, the loop length, and the start offset, as well as switch the loop on and off